How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And a lot of you guys have been asking, does a VPN reduce ping in gaming? Now, you know, in a lot of cases, most cases, in fact, if you don't know what to do or which server to pick, you will end up increasing your ping using a VPN. And typically, of course, not just ping, it will also decrease your speed. So due to encryption, because of the encryption that takes place when you turn on a VPN, your speed will suffer a little bit. Now, a good VPN will minimize that speed drop as much as possible. And this is exactly why I picked these three VPNs. Now, I've done a little testing over a couple dozen VPNs, and these are really just coming out on top in every test. And I do have a small test here where I can show you just a couple of examples here using the French and New York servers and all these VPNs to show you how it works. But now, before we begin, if you guys are interested in any of these VPNs, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews if you'd like to learn more about these VPNs. Now, I know I said, generally speaking, when using a VPN, it'll actually increase your ping and decrease your download speed. Now, there's no way around, increasing your download speed, but there is a way around, in fact, decreasing your ping even lower than your base ping by using a VPN. Now, this will happen when, let's say, the first rule when using a VPN, obviously with gaming, is that first of all, you want to locate your gaming server. I don't need to log into a game to show you guys what I'm talking about here. I'm using this website to test out the ping of each VPN as well as my base ping. And this is typically a very accurate website. I love using this website to test out ping rather than having to get in and out of the game. And it just saves me a lot of time, and it's pretty accurate actually. My ping generally when connecting to France is around 70. So this is my ping when connecting to the Paris server without any VPN. So 70, I have three tests here. So starting with 70, 71, and 70. Now, of course, I have done these tests prior to making the video. I don't want to make the video too long. So yeah, if you want any proof that these tests are not in fact faked, you can take a look at the dates and you'll notice that I started with the base ping and then Express, then Nord, then Surfshark, and I put it in the URL here just to make sure that you guys know which one I'm talking about. So which VPN I'm talking about as I switch in between them, okay? And you can tell that the time will move on as I go from tab to tab, okay? And it's all today, so 26th of March 2022, all right? So just, for you skeptics out there, all right? Now, in order to get good or better ping than your base ping using a VPN, first of all, you want to locate your gaming server, okay? So, I don't know, let's say you're playing Warzone, you're playing in the European region, and you look it up and find out that, well, Warzone or Activision or whoever owns the Call of Duty servers, specifically Warzone, let's say they have servers in France, okay, for the sake of the example, and you are in, I don't know, Bulgaria, okay? If you're in Bulgaria and you're connecting to France, this very distance is going to create a delay. Now, because you are connected to the Bulgarian server, you know, there's going to be a delay. However, if you want to decrease that ping and get an even better ping, I mean, Bulgaria and France are close enough for you to get a great ping, but if you don't improve that ping, what you want to do is connect to a French server. Therefore, your gaming server and the VPN server that you're connected to are going to be close to each other, which will give you an even better ping. That's pretty much how it works. With ping, it's all about distance. So instead of connecting to your gaming server from Bulgaria, you'll be connecting to your gaming server from France itself. where your gaming server also resides. All right, so this is pretty much how it works. And I'll show you guys an example of that. And starting with my base ping here. In the connecting to the French server, and by the way, I selected the same servers here, connecting to the same server. So if you go here, so with the base ping, you'll notice that if I just go to France, it's the edis.at, and it's the same here. I went to edis.at, and I'm always using the same servers of the websites in order to make these tests to just get as much of an accurate result as possible. Okay, so without a ping, without a VPN, excuse me, that'll be 70, 71, and 70. So I did three tests just to kind of get a better idea. Okay, with ExpressVPN, I got a 74, 75, and 72.5, okay? Just so that you guys know, I tested this at 1741, and right here, it's at 1731. So it's all in the same day, and it's just 10 minutes later, all right? Okay, so with ExpressVPN, as you can tell here from the URL, just so that you guys know, which VPN I have tested here. So I got 74, 75, and 72.5, roughly. So we got an increase in ping, roughly 74, 2, 3, 4, 5 ping max. So yeah, the worst we got was a 5 MS increase, which is not bad at all. But still here, the VPN increased my ping rather than decrease it. And I'll show you guys an example where it decreases it. Okay, and it's coming up. So with France, it's 85, 89. With NordVPN, excuse me, in France, 85, 89, and 86. So yeah, definitely not as good of a result as ExpressVPN, because we got an almost 20 MS increase here. So 19 MS increase. 15 MS increase with 85 MS and a 16 MS increase right here. So it's not the best, but it's not bad either. So yeah, pretty good overall. Now with Surfshark, it's 80, so about 10 MS increase. We got good results here with 73, which is, so roughly 80. If you want to average it out, it could be around 75, whereas the average with ExpressVPN could be around, you know, 73, something like that. So, you know, with the French server, I would say ExpressVPN is the best, followed by Surfshark and NordVPN. Now, when I connected to the New York server, and keep in mind that I am near the European region, that's why I'm getting pretty bad ping with New York, but I just wanted to use this as an example. Again, I'm using the same Volter.net server from the website here. And without a VPN, I got 143 MS, 145, and 143 again. With ExpressVPN, I got lower ping, 141, 140, and 140. And that is because the New York server that I connected to with ExpressVPN is closer, obviously, to the server that I'm testing right here. And of course, I am near the European region, so I'm gonna get a pretty high ping when connecting to the States, but still, I was able to lower my ping by using a VPN server that's closer to the server of the website here, of the ping tester. With NordVPN, it's 143.5, 143, and 144.5. So roughly the same as my base ping. So you can consider this result as just neutral, no increase and no decrease. Now with Surfshark, and this is where it gets really interesting, it seems like Surfshark has the closest server to the ping tester server right here. So it even gave me a lower ping, a much lower ping than my base ping. 136, 136, and 135. So this is a great example of decreasing your ping using a VPN. Again, typically speaking, due to encryption, the VPN at the cost of speed will protect your connection. But in this case, and it will worsen both your download and ping, but in this case, you are able to improve your ping rather than worsen it. So yeah, I just thought I'd give you guys a little bit of an example here. Again, if you guys are interested, by the way, in any of these VPNs, they all have great features, you know, such as the kill switch and split tunneling and a handful of protocols. You've got plenty of servers, a no-logs policy, and these VPNs are just great overall, and they will cater to most of you guys in terms of features, performance, as well as budgeting, because you'll have ExpressVPN, let's say, as a premium VPN here being the most expensive, followed by NordVPN, and then Surfshark being the most budget-friendly VPN. So if you guys are interested in learning more about these VPNs, you'll find links to full reviews in the description down below. I'll give you more of an in-depth look into the privacy policy, speed streaming, torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. And you also find links to pricing and discounts if you'd like to take advantage of those discounts while they last. And keep in mind that these VPNs all have a 30-day money-back guarantee and 24/7 live chat support to process your refund with in 3 to 4 days if you are not satisfied with the service for whatever reason. So that'll be it for this video. Comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.